Christmas and welcome to St. Rock. Please stand and join in singing our opening carol, O Come All Ye Faithful.
Face him confidently when he comes again as our judge. who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. For Zion's sake, I will not be silent. For Jerusalem's sake, I will not be quiet, until her vindication shines forth like the dawn, and her victory like a burning torch. Nations shall behold your vindication, and all the kings your glory. You shall be called a new name, pronounced by the mouth of the Lord. You shall be a glorious crown in the hand of the Lord, a royal diadem held by your God. No more shall people call you forsaken, or your land desolate, or your land a spouse. For the Lord delights in you and makes your land his spouse. As a young man marries a virgin, your builder shall marry you. And as a bridegroom rejoices in his bride, so shall your God rejoice in you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm response is, "Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord."
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Paul reached Antioch in Pisidia and entered the synagogue, he stood up, motioned with his hand, and said, "Fellow Israelites, and you others who are God-fearing, listen. The God of this people Israel chose our ancestors and exalted the people during their sojourn in the land of Egypt. With uplifted arm, he led them out of it. Then he removed Saul and raised up David as king. Of him he testified, I have found David, son of Jesse, a man after my own heart. He will carry out my every wish. From this man's descendants, God, according to his promise, has brought to Israel a Savior, Jesus. John heralded his coming by proclaiming a baptism of repentance to all the people of Israel. And as John was completing his course, he would say, What do you suppose that I am? I am not he. Behold, one is coming after me. I am not worthy to unfasten the sandals of his feet. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
This is how the birth of Jesus came about. When his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found with child through the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her husband, since he was a righteous man, yet unwilling to expose her to shame, decided to divorce her quietly. Such was his intention when, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary, your wife, into your home, for it is through the Holy Spirit that this child has been conceived in her. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him, and took his wife into his home. He had no relations with her until she bore a son, and he named him Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
I can truly tell you that God answers our prayers, because for a moment I started sweating when I saw that long version of the Gospel and all those names I can't pronounce, and I said, Lord, please let there be a shorter version. And he answered it. Thank you, Jesus. But everything that we have gone through this year in 2020 was dominated by troubled waters. But as we are people of faith, disciples of Christ, we were able to navigate those troubled waters along the way through this year. Now, this year has been a unique year in all of our lives because none of us have ever seen anything like this before. But for us, we are truly blessed to be able to celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ during this Christmas season. And it is to be able
to celebrate the birth of our Lord, to where through the Advent season we prepare our hearts and our minds to receive him in the infancy of the child. But it's through that infancy of the child that we are saved from all that can harm us. We are saved from anyone who tries to harm us. We are saved, and we will live eventually with our Heavenly Father when our earthly pilgrimage is done. But it was the child who was born to our Blessed Mother, our Blessed Mother Virgin Mary, to where she bore a son and carried him in the tabernacle of her womb, and then laid him in a manger. That manger was a feed trough, a trough to feed animals. And from that same trough, we are fed as well by the divine physician himself, who can heal all of our ailments. And from that moment on, from that moment till now, we are still feeding upon the one who can save us. We are still feeding upon him, and receiving his body and his blood each and every single time we come to this holy place. And it is through this holy place where we receive him from that altar of sacrifice and worship that he has given us, to where we are united with those who have gone before us in heaven, where we are partaking of something of heavenly nature while we are still here on earth. Although there is so much going on in the world, let us never forget that Christ is still King, and our King will take care of his people. All we have to do is believe in him. God gave us a covenant of his Son to save his people, and we, all of our people, no matter how sinful we may be, are his true children. And it's through that salvation where we can redeem ourselves with him through that sacrament of reconciliation. Sorry, my mind is racing and there's a lot going on up here. But I'm trying to get it out as best as I can. But it's through that salvation where our Lord says, these are my beloved people, and these are the ones I will save. My dear brothers and sisters, throughout this Christmas season and throughout, and as we go into 2021, do not forget, God will take care of us. Rely on him, and he will take care of the rest. And I also want to apologize to my at-home viewers. They're probably getting a little fuzziness right now. You know, when you run out of your unlimited plan, so to speak, they slow you down a great deal, so that's probably why they're getting a little fuzziness. My apologies to you. But at least we can hear the word of God and still partake in the Mass from our own homes. Please stand. And we'll bless our nativity scene. God of every nation and people, from the very beginning of creation, you made manifest your love. When our need of our Savior was great, you sent your Son to be born of the Virgin Mary. To our lives he brings joy, peace, justice, and mercy and love. Lord, we ask you to bless all who look upon the manger. May it remain for us humble birth of Jesus, and raise up our thoughts to him, who is God with us, the Savior of all, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us offer our prayers to our Lord.
For the leaders of our church, especially Pope Francis, that through their work they may continue to spread the good news of our Savior, we pray to the Lord. For our parish, that the light of Christ may illuminate our life together, we pray to the Lord. We pray for those who are sick and confined to their homes or in the hospital. May they know that they are not not forgotten during this Christmas season. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all children and young people, that they may know the joy of Jesus' coming every day in our lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have died this past year, and those who are thinking of them especially at this time of Christmas. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those prayers that we offer in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and ever-living God, hear the prayers of your people during this Christmas season. May those prayers be answered in time, according to your will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church.
As we look forward, O Lord, to the coming festivities, we may serve you in all more eagerly, for knowing that in him you make manifest the beginning of our redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. He took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaken of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Charles our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. As we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of God's peace.
Mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my house, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
those who were not able to receive Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, we offer our prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament, and I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray that we may draw ever vigor from celebrating the nativity of your only begotten Son, by whose heavenly mystery we receive both food and drink, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
It's been a pleasure to celebrate Mass with you. It is a blessing to be able to celebrate Mass because some places around the world are not able to do so. So it's truly a gift that we are able to receive our Lord during this time of the year. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Merry Christmas.
Please join in singing our concluding hymn, Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Thank you. Merry Christmas, Father.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
I'm
still poking out the bottom of the closet.